Hey guys, Amit here for Advices Media, and this is a very interesting day today because Motorola is finally launching the Moto X Android smartphone in India today. And I've been using this smartphone from the past over 6 months because I got this in the month of September 2013, and I have been using it on a day-to-day basis, and this has always been my primary device. As you can see, it has the AT&T logo on the back. It's the factory unlocked AT&T device, which actually costed me around $750 because I bought it from a retailer in US, and I finally ended up paying higher customs and shipping, following which the total cost was around 55,000 rupees, which is pretty high. While Motorola is actually going to officially launch this with the online e-commerce retailer in India, that's Flipkart, at a price of around 23,000, which is pretty interesting and recommended purchase price. So if you're looking to buy one of these smartphones, then this video is actually for you. So in this video, I'm going to talk about 10 interesting features or 10 interesting points for which you should actually buy this smartphone, and a few drawbacks or few negativities around this Android device. So first off, let's start off with the most interesting features. So first off, the device comes with a 4.7 inches display with a Gorilla Glass, which means that you don't have to worry about scratches on the same. And I have never used a screen guard, as you can see, on this device from the past 6 months or so, and till now you don't find any scratches on the same. Apart from that, the body is actually made of plastic, and as you can see on the back, it's not textured back, but still the looks actually give you like a textured finish. And since I have been using it from the past 6 months, you can see that there are a lot of scratches and dents on the back, but still it doesn't show clearly, and it's actually kind of invisible unless and until you actually zoom in totally and you look into the same. It's not clearly visible. So overall, if you don't even use a back cover, you can still go fine with the same. Apart from that, the device comes with a 10 megapixel camera on the back and a 2 megapixel camera on the front, while both of these cameras support 1080p video recording. Point is that it comes with a decent benchmark score, that's around 21,000, which is pretty decent considering that these days we have smartphones coming with 35,000 or 38,000 benchmark scores. But this is pretty decent for the price you are paying for this Android smartphone. Now you may also compare this with the Nexus 5, and you may claim that Nexus 5 is also a decent smartphone and also comes with some interesting features, but yes, it doesn't come with the features which Moto X comes with. Most of the Samsung Android smartphones comes with 50 GB of Dropbox kind of storage options, but the Moto X comes with 50 GB of Google Cloud storage, which means that you can host all your important photos and videos directly to the Google Drive. So that is pretty useful. And apart from that, the phone actually comes with a very interesting camera, because the phone actually came with Android 4.2.2, then it was upgraded to Android KitKat. So right now we have Android 4.4.2 update available for this device, which means that Motorola is always pushing the latest updates available for this device to the users, and they can always update their devices to this latest updates. So as you can see, right now we are on Android 4.4, while the 4.4.2 update is being downloaded in the background right now. So overall, the smartphone comes with the latest OS, comes with a very interesting camera, and one of the most interesting features is that it comes with a feature called active display, which means that if the phone is always kept on the desk, the moment you just touch it or if there's any kind of new notification, it will just pop up on the screen instead of you to actually bypass your lock screen and actually check out the notification. So that is pretty useful, and you don't have to worry about the notifications. You can always get them onto the top of your screen. Apart from that, the smartphone comes with a touchless control, which means that you just have to keep the phone on your desk and just keep speaking to it. So let's say, okay Google Now, WhatsApp.
Hello Amit, the time is 9:46 in the morning, nothing much going on right now.
So if you have any kind of notifications, like let's say from WhatsApp or Facebook or any email notifications, it would actually speak out. Apart from that, you can also do a few more different kind of commands through the touchless control feature, like okay Google Now, what's the temperature? It would speak out your the current temperature.
It's 32 degrees in height.
You can also say okay Google Now, find my phone. So in case you're not able to find your phone in your room, you can just say this, and it will actually find your smartphone. The moment you touch your phone, it understands that you have found your phone. So these are few of the interesting features, and one more feature which is my most favorite feature is that you just have to twist your hand and the camera application would start up. So just twist your hand and the camera application is up. Now you can just touch on something and the background objects would automatically get defocused, and you get a very interesting or a very beautiful out picture from this captures. So pretty interesting, I would say. And it comes with the default photo editor application, which does a very fabulous job in editing the pictures. Apart from that, there's also an interesting feature, which is the Motorola Assist, which the device automatically understands if you're driving or if you're sleeping and if you're in meetings. So let's say if you're driving, then the device automatically sets the device into the driving mode, following which if you get a call, you would get a notification. If you get SMS, you would get a notification saying that there's a new message from XYZ person, and if you would like to respond, you can just say yes or no. So that is also pretty useful. Apart from that, in the app drawer area, you would find that a device comes with only the default or the most useful Google based applications, and there's nothing else in this device. So that is going to make sure that you don't get those kind of uses applications which you generally get in other smartphones, especially in Samsung and LG devices. So that is also one interesting point to make a note of. Now let's talk about few of the things regarding which I don't really like this smartphone. First off, it supports only nano SIM, which means that if I would like to switch my SIM card from this smartphone to, let's say, to the Galaxy Note 3 or any other smartphone, I don't have this option because my SIM card has already been converted to a nano SIM, and as you can see, there's a small slot here, and this smartphone only supports nano SIM. So if you want to buy this smartphone, make sure that your SIM is actually converted into a nano SIM, or else you won't get the option to insert your SIM here. And apart from that, it doesn't come with expandable storage, which means that if you would like to increase your storage on this device, it's not possible. You just have to decide first if you would like to go for the 16GB or the 32GB variant, and following that, you need to stick to that. There is also an option of OTG, but I actually tested the OTG feature on this device and it doesn't work. This device won't allow you to connect an external memory to this device, and that's the reason if you feel that you could add external memory also, it's not going to allow you to do that, and the only option is actually rooting your device, and then you can actually use the OTG feature. But there's no option to add an additional memory to this device. So as you can see, it says scan system cannot detect the USB OTG signal, so that's not going to work on this device. And apart from that, the final drawback is that the battery, it comes with a 2200 mAh of battery, and I'm not personally satisfied with the same. Yes, I always keep the location services on all the time, and I generally prefer to keep the brightness at the max, and finally I end up with the battery being dead at the end of the day, which means that the device is not going up to the mark, which I was actually expecting it to run for at least 24 hours, but that's not happening. But Motorola has just announced a new update, which you can see it's being installed in the background, which clearly mentions that it's actually going to fix the battery issues which came up in the Android KitKat update. It's 4.4. So I really hope that that's being fixed, and following that, I could actually recommend the smartphone in terms of the battery also. Apart from that, I have been playing many different games. As you can see, we have played the GTA, we have played the Need for Speed, and a few high-end games, and they were all working flawlessly on this device and there were no issues as such. So overall, this was my personal take on the Moto X Android smartphone. If you would like to buy one, you can check out the links given in the description area below. We have linked to the Flipkart, that's the Indian e-commerce store which is going to make this phone available to you at a interesting pricing of 23,000 rupees, and we also added links to the UK and the US stores. So this was my review on the Moto X. Check out the links in the description area to find more videos around the Moto X which we have covered in the earlier weeks, and stay tuned on Advices Media for more. If you have any questions around the Moto X, feel free to ask me on Twitter at Amit Bhavani, or you could post your comments below, and I'll be happy to